Hello children, we had stopped that how to find out speed, and also in the last class we had studied about how we measure the time. So nowadays we are using advanced, otherwise more technology advanced watches, clocks, and very accurate time we are measuring. In olden days, before the invention of these clocks, our ancestors used many kinds of instruments to measure the time. In your textbooks it is given, see, the sun dial like this, the sun dial, water clocks, sand clocks. So like this our ancestor used to measure the time, and nowadays we are using the smart watches, digital watches, stopwatch. So like that we are using to, and clocks we are using to measure the time. And already we discussed how to measure the distance in 6th standard itself, isn't it? Then how we will measure the speed? What is speed? Speed is nothing but distance covered by time taken. Means what? What is speed of an object? We can define the speed of the object is the total distance covered by the object divided by the total time taken by the object to cover that much distance. So that is called speed, isn't it? So to find out a speed, if we know, otherwise if we measure the distance covered by that object and also the time taken to cover that distance, if we know that, we can easily find out the speed. For example, if your car is moving, cover a distance of 10 meter, and for that it will take 2 seconds to cover 10 meter distance. That car take only 2 seconds. So what is the speed? Just we have to divide the 10 by 2, so it will be 5 this meter per seconds. You know what is this line indicate? This slanting line indicate that per. Sometimes we will use this standing line, slanting line, as the meaning of or, either this or that, the meaning of or. But in the measurements and in units, we are using this slash as per, means m, the meter divided by the second. Okay, so like that we can find out speed. Like the same, here we have three quantities: speed, distance, time. If any two quantities is given and one is asked, it is easier as to find out the unknown quantity. Means if speed is given and time taken also given, they ask, the question is to find out the distance. How will you find? Speed into time equal to distance. Okay. So what we will do? Which one we have to find out? We will keep one side. Here we need to find out speed, so we kept one side and we did this calculation. And if they ask to find out distance, we have to keep the distance there and take the quantity time taken to the next side. So you know, you may studied in maths, that is if any quantity taking from one side to another side of the equal to, its sign will changes. If it is positive, it will become negative, means plus to minus, minus to plus, like the same. If it is in the division mode, it will become as a multiplication, and if it is in multiplication relation, it will become division. So like that, if distance is asked, we will find the distance by multiplying the quantity of speed and with the time taken. Like the same, if time taken is asked, what will you do? We will keep the speed here and we will bring the distance. Time taken is asked, we will bring the distance. Distance is in numerator, so it will come here as denominator. But here the time taken in denominator, so we have to write the reciprocal. So distance by speed equal to time taken. Okay. So if speed is asked, that speed equal to distance covered by time taken. If distance is asked, the formula is speed into time equal to distance. Like the same, if time taken is needed, what is the formula? The formula is distance by speed equal to time taken. Okay? And one more important thing, students, always we have to write the unit also. Unit is very important to the physical quantities, and in maths also it is very important, you know, isn't it? So for distance, what units we are using? We already studied that we are using as meter is the SI unit for distance, and there are the smaller units also in meter, and also the larger unit, like what we are using. Meter as a standard unit, meter, then larger unit means we are using kilometer, smaller unit we are using centimeter or millimeter, isn't it? But normally according to the distance is a smaller one, we are using meter, the distance is a larger one, we are using kilometer is the unit. Like the same for the timetable. Time taken, there are seconds, minutes and hour. Hour we are using as a units. Like the same, the larger time we are using hour and smaller one we are using seconds or minutes. So according to the unit, we have to change the unit of the other quantity also. So the speed's unit is, normally we are taking distance in meter and time taken in seconds.